Today, we use the Spreadsheet workbench in FreeCAD to make it easy to create a hinge or tenon routing template. In this tutorial, we want to use the Spreadsheet workbench to create a simple jig from four plywood pieces that can be used to route a hinge or a loose tenon. The principle is very simple and we used it for the wooden loose tenon jig. A guide bushing rides in a slot and a router bit is cutting a pocket with a certain recess. We use FreeCAD version 0.19 and after switching to the Spreadsheet workbench, we create a new spreadsheet and open it with a double click. We also give it a better name and call it Parameter. This spreadsheet is similar to a very simple version of Excel. You can't use it for a complex analysis, but creating an overview of the most important parameters is quite easy. For our example, we need the width and height of the pocket we want to create, the size of the router bit and the size of the guide bushing that we are using. In the spreadsheet itself, we can calculate the size of the opening. It's the width of the pocket plus the guide bushing diameter minus the router bit diameter. We also create cells for the overall size of the jig, and to keep things simple, we will use 3 times the width and height. There are 2 ways to give a cell a name. For a single cell, you can open the cell properties dialog with a right click and put the name as an alias for the cell. There's a macro that makes things a lot easier. Go to Tools, Add-on Manager, Macros, select the Alias Manager and click Install. Now you will find the alias macro in the macro tab. You select the starting and the end row, and the aliases are automatically set to the names in column A. Next, we go to the part workbench and insert a cube, like we did in the first part of the tutorial. The thickness of the template is 8 mm. For the width, we click on the small circle to enter a formula. In this case, the formula is simple. It is the value of platform width in the parameter spreadsheet. So we write parameter.platformWidth. The height is a bit more complex. It is half of the difference between the entire height of the jig and the height of the slot. The next cube is going to be a smaller piece of the template. Its length it's the height of the template, and the width is half the difference between the entire platform width and the width of the template slot. Next, we want to position the smaller piece at the right place. For this, we change the placement, position, x value of the piece to the same formula that we used for the shorter side of the first piece. With the two shapes ready, we go to the draft workbench and create a clone of our shape. A clone is a copy of the original object that will change its size when the original shape is changed. When a clone is created, the X position becomes a static value. For the model to be fully parametric, we change the formula and take the X position of the original. For the Y position, we move the object by its own width and the width of the template slot. We then repeat the same steps for the long piece. After cloning it, we change its X position. We are done with the model and arrange the windows side by side so we can enjoy the beauty of a fully parametric model. When we change the width and the height of the slot, the model is automatically adjusted. For this model to be of any practical value, we need some measurements that we can take to the saw and cut the template to size. After making sure we look at the top of the model, we switch the tech draw workbench and create a new drawing. With all the objects selected, we add a few of these objects. The view gets scaled down so that it fits on the paper, and after a quick recomputing, we can have a look at the sheet. In this drawing, we can add horizontal and vertical measures by just selecting two points and adding the respective measurement. Also, this drawing is fully parametric. When we change the values of the spreadsheet, the model and the drawing are changing their values. This was only a sneak preview of the tech draw workbench. We will get back to it in a later part and in more detail. Also, don't forget to subscribe for more videos on FreeCAD, and please leave a comment if you want a particular topic to be covered.